Hi guys, it's Ramsey. I know for sure the biggest pain when you get started on ClickUp is you get swamped with notifications. You probably receive hundreds of emails a day telling you someone has updated status, someone changed a task name, someone changed a description, and you're probably going to be overwhelmed and want to leave the tool. Now, we're in June 2024 and ClickUp has just released an update that makes it so much easier to handle your notifications. I'm going to show you how to set up your ClickUp notifications properly, and I'm going to show you how you can get some more peace of mind and declutter your inbox. ClickUp notifications is basically made of three components. First off, there's what triggers the ClickUp notifications. What triggers you as a watcher? A watcher is ClickUp is someone that's watching notifications happening on a task. Let me show you an example. I'll get to ClickUp and open a random task. And if I open that one out, if you get right here, as you can see, I'm a watcher of that task. That's that bell icon here on the top right of any task. And it means I'll be notified for everything I've set up in my notification settings happening on this task. If we get back to our diagram, we have a second point. When do we get notified? And ClickUp allows you to set that up. It allows you to delay your notifications by a certain amount of hours if you wanted to. And my last point is what to get notified on. Basically, the notification you will receive will go through this little filter. That's what I call the notification filter. Something pops up on a task, it's gonna filter out if you are a watcher of that task, if you wanna get notified now or later regarding that task, and what you wanna get notified on. Do you actually wanna receive that information, that event that happened? That's basically how ClickUp notifications are set up. And we're gonna start by setting up what triggers you as a watcher. Let's get into ClickUp and I'll go into my notification settings. To access it quickly, you go here towards your avatar and you click notification settings. Your notification settings will display like so. Everything will be set to default. If you go into the auto watch tasks you're involved in, it will be all on and the smart notifications should be off. If we get back to our diagram, what triggers you as a watcher? We're gonna set that up. Basically, this toggles will let you determine what triggers you as a watcher. And I recommend you to only keep that one when I comment on a task or subtask. That way, you'll be set as a watcher on the task only if someone mentions you, because you don't want to be notified on every single task that you've created. That would be a mess. Set that up when I comment on a task or a subtask. We're going to talk about the next point. When do we get notified? That's smart notifications. Basically, ClickUp lets you delay notification by a certain amount of time if you've been working on that task. As an example, if I get back to my workspace, open up a random task, if I work on that task, add a comment, mention someone, and I mention them and they reply, if I see that comment and answer it within a certain window of time, I will not be notified by ClickUp. And we want to set that up because most of the time you'll be working on your day-to-day and there might be some tasks that you're actually working on. You don't want to get a notification on top of it. We'll delay this by 3 to 6 hours. I recommend setting that to 3 to 6 hours. I'll set it to 3 for the example. If I'm answering to a notification or a comment in the ClickUp inbox or within a task, if it's within that window of 3 hours, I'll not be notified. I will not get anything in my inbox. And I'll have a clutter-free inbox. Now, these were the two easiest points. But the last point, what to get notified on, is a little bit tricky because ClickUp offers you 4 notification channels. There's your inbox, which is basically, if I get to ClickUp this area, and I have a dedicated video on how to manage your ClickUp inbox, so you can have a look at that. But your inbox is the main spot for notifications. Then we're gonna have emails. And that's basically all the emails you get in the beginning when you start using the software is probably what clutters you. And everything you receive by email, you probably received in your inbox. If there is 100 notifications popping up in your inbox, it's probably because you haven't set them properly. There's inbox, there's emails. Then next we have browser and mobile. Browser is actually your computer browser. If you're using Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge, Firefox, if you've turned on the notification of that web browser, you will get pops up from ClickUp each time something is updated. Usually it will appear in the top right of the screen or the bottom right, depending on whether you're using Windows or Mac. And then the last one is mobile. Mobile is a notification you're going to get on your phone through the ClickUp app. To receive them, you have to have downloaded the ClickUp app, because even if you've kept them on in ClickUp, you're not going to be notified if you haven't downloaded the app on your phone. Now, here's my recommendation. Turn those off. You really don't need it. And I would argue to turn the emails off as well. But we'll compromise a little bit on that one, because very often you haven't gotten into the habit of checking your ClickUp inbox. As a transition, we'll set up some specific notifications for your emails. This one's kind of a middle ground, and these ones I recommend to turn it off. Now, second point, on each of these channels, you need to determine what to be notified on. And the only thing we're gonna leave is comments. We're only gonna be notified on our comments. And I'm gonna show you how to set that up in ClickUp. Let's get back there. I'll get to my notification settings again. And for the emails, I'll just keep mentions only. Only receive notifications for mentions. And finally, for the inbox, I'll go into the custom settings. I will only keep what I can't turn off. Only the assigned comments and the comments assigned to me, comments I'm mentioned in, new comments, and then turn everything else off. That way, I'll only be notified on what matters, because by default, ClickUp has kept mandatory some notification that actually matter. But the rest you don't really care about. You just turn it off, turn it off, turn it off, turn it off, and keep this one on. As you can see, we've only kept what is turned on by default in ClickUp, and this is more than enough to handle your notification inbox. I'll click save, and that way I'll only be notified when I comment on a task on a subtask. And if I haven't worked on it within 3 hours and through my inbox on what matters, only on the mandatory notification, and through my emails, only on mentions. And once you get going with ClickUp and you get better at it, you can just turn that off and disable your notifications on your emails fully, because ClickUp is made to be used in your day-to-day. You want to check out your inbox very often, and you want to handle your back and forth with your coworkers through your inbox. I hope this video helped you out. I hope it brought you some insight and best practices. Now, if you want some more help, and if you don't want to miss anything when you set up ClickUp, you can access my free checklist. The link is in the description, and you can go through all these checklists and make sure your workspace is set up accordingly. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Stay productive.